Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. Thanks for joining us again today. And we've got a very short video for you to show you how to create a text-based drop-down menu in Wix for your website. So to do this, you'll obviously need a number of pages on your website. I'm just using a simple template for demonstration purposes today. And I've created a home page, a subscribe page, and a policy page. Okay, so that's the first step, is that you'll have to have, obviously, other pages that you want to create as sub pages for your page, which I'll show you in a second. So all of this is done through the pages and menu button here on the left hand side of the editor. So when you navigate here, you can see that all my pages are listed here in order. Now to create a drop down menu for these pages, it's done through a system called Subpages, like I just mentioned, and that works with these little three dots here on the right hand side. So when you hover over a page and select it, it obviously navigates to that page, but you can obviously as well see this little menu here on these three dots. So that allows you to hide the page, you know, from user view. It also allows you to create a sub page from using that page. So if I do that, you can see the link very obviously has occurred there. Okay. So from the home page, I've now got a sub page called subscribe. So I've set that subscribe page as a sub page for the home page. Okay. So when you preview that, you'll see what I mean. Okay. So when I now click or hover over home, you can see that subscribe now appears as a sub page for that. And if I go back to my editor and then I go back to pages again, I'll use policy. And also make that a sub page. Okay, and you can see that it's joined the subscribe page as well in this little spider diagram of sub pages. And now again, just to demonstrate, if I go back to preview, and all you can see now is the home page. And when I hover over it, you can see my subscribe and policy pages appear. Okay, so this uses a hierarchical system. So basically, if you want to undo that first as well, is same again, those three little dots. And if you go back to create a main page, so as opposed to it's a sub page, it's now a main page again. You can see it now appears in the list. And I'll do the same for the subscribe, create that as a main page again. So whatever page is above the page that you want to turn into a sub page, it's going to automatically make it a sub page of that. So for that to make sense, it's a lot easier for me to demonstrate this. So say if I wanted to now create a sub page on subscribe, which is the policy one, because it now exists below it in this list, it takes the hierarchy into consideration. If I now go and create a sub page with that, you can see that it's gone to subscribe instead of home. So again, when I hover over it in preview mode, you can see I've got my home page and my subscribe, which when I hover over, policy appears. Okay, so it matters which order they appear in that list. So to make something a sub page of another page, that's all you've got to do is drag it below that page. And you can see that all you've got to do is left click and drag those pages to reorder them. Obviously, home page usually stays at the top and whatever you want in order of importance then below. That concludes the tutorial for today. Hope you enjoyed. If you'd like one-on-one professional level tutoring and support, there's a link to that in the descriptions for this video. We'll provide that for you. If you like the video, and give us a subscribe to the channel and a like for more content like this. And if you've got any ideas for future videos or anything in specific that you want to know, please leave us a comment below as well. Thank you very much.